Hello, my name is John McCoy. I played 4 seasons in the Liverpool League. And I was an assistant coach at Stanford University. And then I had Marcel Gleason, who was in Oklahoma for 3 months. I'm diagnosed with what is called a brain injury. What happened to me is a lot like one guy woke up stumble. This was a wake-up call to me. I was always very active in the church, but now my faith is to whom Elizabeth mounts. So, Romans 10 says, so, then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. So I'll hear what I have to say. Here are some faith readings that have helped me through my struggles. In 1 John 17, it has the story of David and Goliath. And David, I don't of gravel, but essence of hard work, dedication, and perseverance. I was nervous about walking in, yet now I took gravel and CrossFit. It's all like John chapter 5, when Jesus told the man, rise, take up thy bed, and walk. And immediately the man was made whole and walked. And we can do that. We just need to have faith in God to take that first step. And look, chapter 1, it says, for with God nothing shall be impossible. And the key is with God. We have to do our part to work with Him. We can't just say, well, God's got it. I don't have to do anything. It's the same thing. But you can't say, well, I'm Christian because God's forgiving. The most famous verse of thy promise is John 3:16, and Tim Tebow famously wrote that on just what black shift. In Matthew 22, we are given how we may be saved by Jesus. Jesus said to them, love thy God with all thy heart and all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And in Proverbs chapter 3, it tells us that we'll end up with the reason greater than what we started as by a curse of our faith. God has made us the way we are, so we don't need to ourselves from Him at all. He created us and knows us intimately. My friend Lewis House wrote a book called The Mask of Masculinity, and in that he describes how we mask our facades to what we're so cursed about, but we don't do to hide anything from God. Psalm 139 tells us how God created us so He knows our sins and weaknesses and our struggles. So, Ephesians chapter 4 says, don't let any wholesome come out of her mouth. Finally, light is over, folding us up, opening to the knees. So that just gave to me how I need to be about it, because what I say is always understood, so I need to make it count. So God's doing his job, we have to make his commandment. So Abram had better estimate this little bit of heaven, said, even though it's a courage to go to seek realization, he doesn't want that, because that implies he said faithfully, and that's very far from the case. And I don't look for blessings of feeling, because I know the God's working wonders with me. I do things I should not be supposed, nor thought I would do. So, the same thing is with the recognize the miracles that God works in you.